students, today I will explain you the concept of pin photodiode, which is nothing but a photodetector. Broadly, photodetectors are classified by three types, and they are solar cell, pin photodiode and avalanche photodiode. But in the present lecture, I will concentrate more on the pin photodiode. So I will explain the full concept of pin photodiode, starting from its basic principle, its construction, working and applications. So if we look at the word pin, so a pin photodiode is a three layer device or three component device, in which P stands for P type of extrinsic semiconductor, and I stands for intrinsic region or intrinsic layer, and N is nothing but N type of semiconductors. So you, in this device structure, you can observe that a plus symbol on the both P and N. So these plus symbol will represent that both the P and N type of semiconductors are heavily doped. So because of this heavily doping, they will get very large number of charge carriers, that is electrons and holes. So in this device structure, this P terminal will act like anode and the N terminal will act like cathode. So we can also say that a pin diode is nothing but, in the case of pin diode, an intrinsic layer, which is nothing but pure form of semiconductor, and this intrinsic layer will not have any free charge carriers. That means the resistivity of the intrinsic layer is very high, and the resistivity of the P and N type of semiconductors are very low. So the pin photodiode can also be said that an intrinsic layer is sandwiched between the two heavily doped P and N type of semiconductors. So this is the structure of pin photodiodes. Pin photodiode will works like a photodetector only whenever it is connected in reverse bias. So that means this P terminal is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, and N terminal is connected to positive terminal of the battery through a resistor. So this is positive terminal. So whenever this pin diode is connected in reverse bias, so depletion region, which is formed between the P and N type of semiconductors, is extends. So depletion region will extends, and at the very large reverse bias voltages, the length of the depletion region will becomes equal to length of the intrinsic region. So that means in the case of pin photodiode, the area available for light capturing is very high. Why? Because depletion region is widens in the case of pin photodiode. So this pin photodiode will works like a photodetector only whenever it is connected in reverse bias. So now we will observe the structure of, exact structure of pin diodes. So in the case of pin diodes, I said these pin diodes will works like a photodetector, and its function is to convert the light energy into electrical energy. So whenever light of sufficient energy, that means light is nothing but photons. So whenever photons having sufficient energy, that is h mu, is greater than or equal to Eg, that is energy band gap of the semiconductor, that means whenever light is having this intensity or energy falls on the pin photodiode, then this photon will give the energy to the atoms which are present in the semiconductors, and gaining the energy from these photons, the atoms are excited, and that leads to generation of electron and hole pairs, electron and hole pairs in the depletion region. So electron and hole pairs are generated or produced in the depletion region because of interaction of photons and electrons, and these generated electron and hole pairs will experience a very high force due to the barrier electric field which is present in the depletion region. So this high electric field will separates the both charge carriers, that is electrons and holes, to the opposite direction. That means our charge carriers are separated. So charge carrier separation will happen because of the very high electric field present in the depletion region, and this charge carrier separation will leads to accumulation of very large amount of charge carriers on the two metal contacts. So and this charge carrier separation also leads to the electrical current. So in this way the light energy is converted into electrical energy in the case of pin photodiodes. So when compared with the normal PN junction diode, in the case of pin photodiode, the area available for light capturing or the depletion region is very large. So that for that reason this pin diodes will convert the optical energy into electrical energy, and these pin diodes are very sensitive than the normal PN junction diodes. And in this pin photodiodes, the current, our output current, is generated only because of the light energy. Only because of the light, it current is generated only because of light, not because of the external battery. So that is the reason we will denote the current as IP, which is nothing but photo current. So the generated photo current is equal to the product of charge of the carriers into number of charge carriers which are present in the semiconductors. So in the case of pin photodiodes, our output, that is electrical current, is generated only because of the incident light energy, but not because of the reverse bias or external battery. So this is the working of pin photodiode. So this pin photodiode will acts like a variable resistor whenever it is connected in forward bias, but it will acts like a capacitance whenever it will connected in reverse bias. Applications of pin photodiode. So this pin photodiode which works like a photo detector will be used as a receiver in the case of fiber optics communications. That means this pin photodiode will receives the light signals which is transmitted through the optical fiber cables. And one more application of this pin photodiode is these are used as radio frequency switches, and these are also can be used as high voltage rectifiers. And they are also used as radio frequency attenuators and phase shifters. So the main function of the pin photodiode is to convert the light energy into electrical energy. That means it will act like a photo detector, and it will also act like a receiver in the case of optical fiber technology or optical fiber communication technology. So these are the applications of pin photodiode. One more interesting property of the pin photodiode is, I said that this pin photodiode will works only in reverse bias. So to run the pin photodiode, very small values of voltage, that is in the order of 2 to 5 volts, very small values of voltage are needed to run the pin photodiode. So very low, that means very low reverse bias voltage is required to run the or to operate the pin photodiode. So this is all about the pin photodiode, whose main function is to convert the light energy into optical light energy into electrical energy. And these pin photodiodes are also used in the fields of sensors.